Back to life, right here on Coastal Radio SA. Brad Cunningham with us in the studio this morning, having an absolute blast. I'm enjoying every second of it, and I'm really honoured to have you in the studio with us, Brad. What a pleasure.
The Big Cigar.
Brad, you know, unfortunately, as you know, time catches up with us.
Yes,
but I would like for us to take, or try and summarise exactly what you do and what are your expectations in terms of the outcome of Success Loops.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Because we spoke about that, and you know, it's motivational and you help people and da da da.
And motivational speaking with a difference. It's not just talking. It involves music. It involves using loops. It involves, because everything in life is cyclical. It's entertaining as well as training. It is basically touching by getting in touch. I do a bit of research beforehand. I'd actually have a meeting with the company beforehand, find out what the company culture is, find out what is going on there, so that I can make it more relevant. Because I am addicted to this premise. The difference is I'm not going to get fulfillment unless a difference gets made. I want to do a bit of research, find out what's going on, then touch on the bases and make it as relevant as I can, even including songs that I can tie relevance in, to anchor this so that people can remember it. Because motivation kind of works like this. Motivation isn't kind of that you have a team come in and you get motivated and you expect this now to last for the rest of the year. It doesn't work like that. Motivation is like eating. You don't have breakfast and for the rest of the and starve yourself until the next breakfast. You don't just shower once a week or once a month. You do it every single day. So it's about washing
yourself. Consistency of constantly doing.
Yes.
Because that sort of feeds the mind, it feeds the soul, and from there, you're going to see change. Change will then happen. Using music in motivating people.
Yes. So
and I think it's just a brilliant idea.
Thank you. So this is a way of doing it completely differently, because you want it to last for longer. You want to anchor it. You want to make a huge impact. And in this way, it actually does, because it hasn't been done before. And in this way, I can awake, because everybody has magic inside of them. Everybody does. We spend our lives trying to live like copies, and that's not how we were created. Every one of us is created differently, and we need to learn to be able to embrace that difference, because that is your unfair advantage. That's what, because I'm now doing courses, I'm addicted to this stuff. I'm doing courses, I'm doing webinars. I am constantly on the search. I've got 1,000 emails that still need to be checked out, and I don't even know if I'll get to all of them. But that's how addicted I am to this. And
you're constantly skilling yourself.
Yes.
And you have to. And this is something you've got to do in life.
Now,
any individual, you've got to constantly skill and sharpen your pencil a bit.
And play to where your magic lies. I mean, each of us. I always say that everyone's a world champion. And it's like, how do you mean you're a world champion? It's because nobody can be more you than you, because you are
you.
They are the collector's item.
Yeah.
And so it's all about just trying to expose that. You know?
So basically what you then do is you move into a company, you've got all these individuals there.
Yes.
You sort of break the ice by doing a bit of a song, and then sort of pull them in. And you sort of ignite that little you in each and every one of them.
Yes.
Because some people in companies, especially within the corporate environment, and I'm just saying this because I've seen it, is that they feel that, you know what, irrespective of what I say, they're not going to take notice. Who am I? I mean, I'm just this little pawn in the company.
Yeah.
And that you sort of bring that out. And you sort of let that individual pop out. And that individual can make a difference.
Yes.
In the whole structure of a business.
Absolutely.
Am I correct in saying?
Yeah, absolutely correct in saying that. Obviously, it's got to be relevant to that business.
Indeed.
Obviously, want to mold the corporate culture in that, because every company has its culture. I would try and find out what that is first, and then let everyone know that everybody is not just a pawn in the chess.
Spoke in the wheel.
In the chess game that is that company. You're much more than that. I mean, it's...
You know what? You just said something, and this is what a lot of people feel, is that being in corporate, is one hell of a chess game, and I've just got to really play the game carefully.
Yes.
Some people just play it enough so that they are not being noticed.
Yes.
Some people play more because they want to be noticed, but they get noticed for the wrong stuff.
True.
And what you then essentially doing is, and again, I'm going back to the individuals within the company, is you're going to get them seen, but seen for the correct reasons and what positive impact they could have as individuals within this whole business corporate structure thing.
Yes, we kind of lose ourselves a lot in the corporate industry. We kind of lose ourselves a lot and I would really like to just introduce people back to their infinite potential.
Mm.
To because a lot of us just go chug along on automatic, and it's time to, I think it's an awakening needs to happen, you know. Mm-hmm. And it's a lot of people. I mean, you've got to be real about it as well. So, I mean, it's not just about, a lot of people say, well, I haven't found my passion in life. I haven't found my purpose. And for me, it's kind of like, yes, that can be really, really complicated. And so why not, while you're waiting, instead of trying to live a life with passion, with purpose, instead of trying to find it? Because if you're living a life with passion and with purpose, you have basically, you found something at least that is, and you will get fulfillment out of it.
Indeed.
And it is about going to bed at night feeling that you've, with some kind of satisfaction, some kind of fulfillment, because that's what's seriously lacking in this day and age. People are unfulfilled, even those that are successful. I mean, how many times do you see huge celebrities that basically end their lives and they've had huge success and yet they're so unhappy? I mean, it's more about success. The definition of success is more about satisfaction, contentment and fulfillment than it is actually about joy, happiness, and wealth, and just money.
Because a lot of people measure happiness.
Not that there's anything wrong with money. I think we all deserve prosperity.
I
so
I wouldn't mind having more of that.
Yeah,
nobody. No, really, I wouldn't.
And we're worthy. We deserve it.
Indeed, we do. Mm. Indeed, we do. And we sort of sometimes, I'm not worthy of it. And you sort of cut yourself. There's this little cut off that you have because I think we are so focused on surviving,
yeah,
then we are actually focused on
thriving.
There we go.
Yeah, surviving, not thriving. And that's been belted into us from school days. I mean, there was always somebody faster than us, more clever than us, more talented than us in school, and we all had to told we just had to fit in, and we all had to be told that you need to be able to study or get this so that you can have a secure, and I'm saying that with inverted,
yeah, and inverted commas,
inverted commas, yes. When it's I don't believe that we were built to stand out. That's why we're all different.
Mm.
It's not about just surviving. It's about thriving, and that's more than just building up a lot of money.
I think so. Time for us to listen to a bit of music now. You got to choose, because I'm now going to be pulling. If you look right at the top, the Brad. Dick, he's the one, and Dick B is the other one. Now, you got to choose which one you would like for us to play. You got to give me the title as well, because I forget.
Show me. While talking about money, I had a great collaboration with a very talented guitarist by the name of Grant Trigellis, who's a close friend of mine as well.
Mm-hmm.
And we did he came up with a riff, and then said, Brad, I need some lyrics. He came up with the chord progression, then I came up with the riff, because I said, well, this sounds like kind of an AC/DC kind of thing. Angus Young, what would he come up with? So I came up with this little riff. We had a lot of fun. I came up with a whole bunch of lyrics, and show me the money came out of it. And it is, man, what a song. I love it.
Amazing stuff. So this one is called Show Me the Money.
Show Me the Money.
The Big Cigar.